Okay, let's carry on with the same number. We're going from, so this is the Great Ships 3 going into the Raging Sea, and we're going from bar 67. And the soprano sing the sea, the sea, the sea. Now becomes a mortal enemy. The sea. Try that. Let's do that again. If any other parts want to try and sight reading their part, they're welcome to. But I'll be bashing out the soprano line. Ready? 3, 4, 1.
The sea. The sea. The sea.
Okay, altos, it goes.
The sea, the sea, the sea, the sea, the sea, the sea. Now becomes a mortal enemy.
Just do the now becomes and.
Now becomes a mortal enemy. The sea, the sea, the sea, the sea, the sea, the sea, now becomes a mortal enemy.
All right, let's have the sopranos and altos together from bar 67. 3, 4, 1.
The sea. The sea. The sea. Now becomes a mortal enemy. The sea.
Good, well done. Tenors. Woo, you've got a jump at the beginning of this. You jump up a six. You go.
The sea.
Go from now, mortal enemy. Bar 73, 3.
Now, mortal enemy. The sea, the sea. The sea, the sea.
I'm doing the basses, then we'll do tenors and basses together, right? So, the C, and one. Tenors and basses together. The C basses, the C tenors, and one. Sopranos, the C, and altos, the C. We should have a lovely clash there with the tenors for a moment. Three, four, might as well all learn this, because we all get to sing this melody in a minute anyway when we go into unison. So let's have everybody singing bar 83 soprano line, and it goes,
when the raging sea
slightly faster. Three, four, one.
When the raging sea declares war, we battle for survival, not for victory.
Good. Altos. When the rain it goes, one,
when the raging sea declares war, we battle for survival alone, not for victory.
Slightly tricky, do you want me to divide it up? Or just sing it through a couple more times? Yeah? Three, four, one.
When the raging sea declares war,
that declares war. You can see you're the only people doing something there. Really bring that one out, because also it's a lovely dissonance with the sopranos on holding their D. Declares war. Okay, do you want to do it once more? And one.
When the raging sea declares war, declares war, we battle for survival alone, not moving to be.
I'm hearing someone wants to go up on Not for Victory, but it's all on one note.
Not for victory.
Yep. Okay, and the tenors. Oh, actually, no, let's just do the sopranos and altos together once. Sopranos and altos together, bar 83. And one.
Good.
Happy with that? Nearly. Do you want to do it again?
Yes.
Okay. Bar 83 and one. I did a really bad thing there. I did the wrong rhythm.
Yeah.
The rhythm is not what I sang, but declares war. One. Declares war. And one.
Declares war. We battle for survival.
So let's do it again with both parts from the When the Raging Seas, sopranos and altos. And one. When the Raging Sea, bar 83, and
when the raging sea, declares war, we battle for survival alone, not the victory.
So I've forgotten, I give you a C sharp. For the whole bar against the sopranos. You're singing up there, war, they're singing war, war, war. Getting right up to war, you're up there, war. Okay, this will be interesting, Sam. Okay, tenors again, and one.
When the raging sea, the raging sea.
Lone is only one beat. Lone breath. Lone breath.
Not the victory.
So that's quite long tailed. We'll do the basses in a. Oh, I didn't even record it.
Can we do it together, please?
Yeah, okay. So this is the tenors from bar 83. And one.
When the raging sea, the raging sea declares war.
And now the basses, and then we'll do tenors basically. Okay, same place, bar 83, and one.
When the raging sea.
Somehow a tie has appeared in the music between taught and is it in your copy as well? In bar 90? Or is it not in yours? Is it only in mine?
I'm not between Tor and
Reed. No, good, okay. Don't want to tie Tories together. let's do that again. Bar 83, basses, and one.
When the raging sea declares war, we battle for survival, not for victory.
And now tenors and basses together. 3, 4, 1.
When the raging sea
just add the alto to build it up. So from bar 83, 3, 4, 1. Seven that late? Okay. Let's try it again. At 83, I'll try and just play the parts. I won't bother with the piano accompaniment. I'll try and play the parts. 3, 4, 1. Quite the right place at 86. Can we do it again? But I'm really going to concentrate on the outers, right? 3, 4, 1. Better, Vera? Should we do it once more? Are you okay now, tenors? Yeah? Bass is okay? Let's add the sopranos then. Yeah. No, you weren't supposed to be that time, but let's add them now. Okay. Alright, from 83, everybody. And I shall bash out the soprano part as you haven't been singing for a while. 3, 4, 1. Hear the tenors and the sopranos. Just because there was so much going on there, I couldn't really concentrate on that distance. It gives me a thrill. Okay, 3, 4, 1. Could you hear it? Could you feel those vibrations, that kind of bzzz buzz? Okay, all right, let's do all the parts again one more time. 83. Okay, 83. 3, 4, 1.
And then in unison, when the raging sea
supposed to not last that long, but actually it sounded lovely lasting that long. I think we might extend it, yeah. And lovely with those low F sharps and the basses. Excellent, really nice. Is anyone desperate to go over any of that again, or can we do the whole number? Whole number? Do you want to do the ooze again? Because we... The ooze. Bar 47. Let's just do the ooze once more. So, here's two bars in. It's very soft, remember there's a narration on top of this. Let's do it all the way from the beginning. Would you like to stand? So it's altos and tenors first, and then sopranos and basses first, and altos and tenors. Okay, so here's the introduction again.
Thank you.
So I know you're not confident on every single note there is to sing, but the do please use your CDs to help you learn the parts. We have 5 minutes, which is a really awkward amount of time. Do you want to, there isn't time to learn something new. Do you want to sing something that we've already sung? Oh, all right. Far away. No, it's not going to be humorous. We could all end up in tears. Far away in Olive Grove, number 22, it's the penultimate number. Okay, for those people who haven't sung this before, Far Away in Olive Grove, it's the one before the last. And so some people know this because we've done it in choir before, but you need to know the melody is a solo, but you can, I'll sing the solo, but when you're not singing something else, you're welcome to sing along with me. When you see CHO stroke SOP, chorus soprano, everybody sings that. If you haven't got part of your own, if you haven't got an alto part or a tenor part, or a, there is a now tenor part, but you don't, we haven't done the copies yet. I don't think you haven't got a tenor part in yours, have you? No. So, just for now, I've added a tenor line.
Yeah, but have you swapped it?
I'm sorry?
Those I printed out today, would they be new?
Oh! Yeah. I think so. Yeah, sorry, I forgot to say if you don't have a separate tenor part, just sing the tenor bass part for now.
We have a little bit where we left, I've got a note, leaping between chorus and line and tenor bass part.
Yeah, that's where I'm
different. Oh, sorry.
So, if you don't have it, everybody sings, all the time that the chorus is singing, you will sing. If you don't have a tenor part or an alto part or a bass part written, you sing the soprano line, what's written as chorus soprano, yeah? Okay? Yeah. So.
Who sings the melody, David? Because
you've got both on the line, who sings the melody? I sing the melody, but if you want to join in with me when you haven't got your own part to sing, that's fine. Just sing anything. That fits.
Far away in an olive grove, the sun is shining, the sky is blue. My family will be working there, how I wish I could be there too. When I speak my dream, I see that olive grove in my desire. Then it seems so much more real than this cold, gray sea and sky.
Now move to your part.
The time.
Stranger, stranger, stranger.